Hi, my name is Victoria Yampolsky, and I run the Startup Station. The Startup Station is a comprehensive financial resource for early stage startups that provides educational, consulting, and media resources for first-time entrepreneurs. In this video, I'd like to talk about the do's and don'ts of using comparables. One of my clients recently asked me if he can use an information about how much money a comparable company was raising is a direct guide to determine how much money his company would raise. Now, of course, comparables are very important, and the multiples that you derive from comparables are used to determine an exit value or a terminal value of your company. So by no means do I suggest to discard the information that comparables give you. However, you can't just blindly take it. You need to adjust this information based on your situation for the following four reasons. Number one, a comparable company may have a business model that could be slightly different from yours, which will result in their capital needs being slightly different than yours. Number two, their cost structure could be different, which again will result in their capital needs not being the same as for your company. Number three, they can be at a different stage of development and therefore either need more or less money than you are at your current stage. For example, if you're looking at a comparable that raising money at a Series B round and you are raising money at a Series A round, then of course they will be raising more money because at their stage, they need more capital in order to get to the next step. Whereas you at the Series A stage need less capital. And finally, number four, the amount of capital that a comparable may have to start with may differ from the amount of capital that you have. For example, if they had a large investor that gave them an initial startup capital, they may not need as much money at the next stage, regardless of what is typically raised at that stage. Similarly, if you had more capital available to you, then your capital needs will be lower than those of the comparable companies. For all of these reasons, you can't blindly look at how much money comparable companies are raising and say that you would need exactly the same. What you should do is to build a financial model based on your company fundamentals and to derive the amount of funding that you require from this financial model. To learn how to build a financial model, please go to www.thestartupstation.com and look at our curriculum. And of course, you can contact me at victoria@thestartupstation.com as well. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.